instead of thinking about the loss of this person, see it as this new adventure that you're about to embark on. See it as a new opportunity. See it as like a fresh adventure for yourself to move on and to go into this new kind of era of your life without this person. Walking away and no contact. How to do it effectively. Hi guys, my name is Christine and I'm a dating, relationship and personal development coach. And today I'm talking about no contact and walking away and how to do these things effectively. And I feel like a lot of people do this in the wrong way, that they're using it as a tool to get someone back in order to reattract them. And they're kind of using it as a kind of like a manipulation thing when they haven't really committed really to really walking away. Because when you do no contact and when you walk away from someone, you really have to mean it. You really have to realize that, hey, you know what, this person isn't interested in me, or this ex is not coming back into my life. I have to kind of come to terms with that right now, and the best way I can do that is actually by walking away, by saying, you know what, this person can take it or leave it. And that's the kind of attitude that you need to have. You need to have the attitude of, you know what, this person can take it or leave it, but at this current time, I'm not going to spend any more time on this person. I'm not going to waste any more emotion on this person. I'm no longer going to talk to them because for whatever reason, they've become less enthusiastic about me. So I should not give them any more of my energy, any more of my attention. So therefore, I'm walking away and I'm not contacting them anymore. And if they want to come back into my life, that's great. But if they don't come back into my life, that is also great. That is the true mindset of someone who is walking away and goes into no contact. You have to have that attitude, right? You have to really believe that this person may never come back. And most importantly, you're okay with that. So you might not be okay with that, and that's fine, because at this current time you might not be quite over it, especially if you've invested a lot of your time, a lot of your emotions into this person. So if you've invested a lot of time, a lot of emotions into this person, then of course it's going to be a lot difficult for you to walk away currently, to really walk away and mean it, to really go into that no contact without the intention of ever contacting them again, because that's what no contact is, you know, not contacting them with the intention of never contacting them again, right? And a lot of people are not ready to quite let go of that person. So they kind of always think, well, okay, well, maybe in a few weeks I'll message them to kind of test the waters to see where things are. If that's you, if you feel like that's you, then you haven't quite got into the place where you really should be doing no contact. You haven't quite got there yet. So what you need to do in this kind of situation is you need to give yourself a bit of time, right? Obviously, always the best method is to do no contact. But during that time, you need to kind of heal and get over that person, because otherwise no contact isn't going to work for very long. At some point you may feel the urge to reach out to them, and if you ever feel the urge to reach out to them, then you haven't truly mastered moving on and walking away from this person. So no contact for you is probably going to feel really, really excruciating, right? If you haven't quite moved on yet, if you're not ready, right? So in order to kind of get to that place where you can truly walk away from someone, where you can feel like you can do no contact forever, you need to have time and space to heal and to get over it. And I always think the best method to do this is to focus on other areas of your life, to focus on other areas that bring you a lot of meaning, right? So this could be your career, this could be your hobbies, this could be your friends, this could be your health, right? Putting other areas of your life are more of the forefront, and having your relationships as something that's kind of secondary or even further back than that. So basically, you need to have a different mindset shift when it comes to walking away, no contact. Because remember, no contact must be forever. Walking away must be forever. You must see it as something that could be forever. This person may never come back. So one of the best things for you to do is to actually shift and think about it in a different way. Instead of thinking about the loss of this person, see it as this new adventure that you're about to embark on. See it as a new opportunity. See it as like a fresh adventure for yourself to move on and to go into this new kind of era of your life without this person. And once you see it as a kind of like a new or an exciting adventure or new exciting opportunity for you to learn more about yourself, to grow, to do different things, to have more time on your hands, then you feel a little bit more excited about this journey of not contacting them again and walking away from this person, walking away from those old emotions and those old habits. And to see it more as freedom, feel like you are free to do whatever you want to do. Because, you know, if we see life as an exciting adventure with new opportunities that could be just around the horizon, then you're not so focused on the past and the past things that have happened to you and these past people that you were once attracted to, or you may still be attracted to, right? So seeing life in this new way just makes it feel a lot more better, a lot more exciting for yourself, because this is a new opportunity. The reason why a lot of people find videos like this one, the reason why a lot of people search for videos like this one, is because they've gone through so much pain, so much hurt from their relationships, that they just want things to change. They want something new. They want something different. And it may be the fact that they, you know, do want the ex back or something, but what they really want is something better. Like, what you really need is something a lot better, a lot more meaningful. So you've gone through all this hurt, you've gone through all this pain from this person. It may have been a crush, it may have been an ex, and now you're in a whole new different kind of situation where you're about to move into a new different era of your life. And what's really cool about this is that, from my own experience, the most painful experiences of my life were ones that kind of catapulted me into a new kind of era of my life, where I just grew so much more and become so much better as a person. I had to go through pain in order to get to it. So there's like this concept in religion, right, which is like the way of the cross, which is essentially, you know, the worst thing that happens to you happens to be the best thing that happens to you, because it kind of like moves you into this new dimension, or heaven, shall we say. Right, so like basically the worst experience of your life happens to be actually the best thing for you, because it changes your life so dramatically. And this is why I don't really mind if bad things, like if I feel a lot of hurt in my life over something, it could be to do with my business, it could be to do with my relationships, it could be to do with some other kind of like crisis. I don't mind so much when those things happen, because I know they're about to change me into a certain, and they're going to take me onto a new and interesting path. And a lot of people, you know, they kind of stay in the pain. They don't realize that this is a new opportunity for growth. They don't realize that this is a new opportunity for change. It's only when people get to that point, when they realize that, you know what, I could be moving on into new and better things right now, that's when they really start to walk away properly. That's when they really, you know, go into no contact, basically, without that kind of added baggage that kind of makes them want to kind of check up on their ex, kind of check up on their crush, see what they're doing, see what they're up to. So you really need to get to that place. And once you realize that life is a more exciting adventure, and that pain can actually catapult you into better new eras of your life, into a whole new brilliant chapter, that's when you don't mind so much when someone kind of rejects you. You don't mind it, because you're like, okay, well, moving on to bigger and better things. You know, that's why that cliche said, you know, moving on to bigger and better things, because that's usually what happens. And if you hear a lot of cliches, you know, pay attention to cliches, because they're a cliche usually because it's true, right? That's why it gets said over and over and over again. So something I'd like you to do, or something I'd like you to think about, you might want to write this down, but, you know, think about what you would like your life to be like in 5 years' time, right? We don't want to project it too far. We don't want to do something like 20 years, because sometimes that can seem a bit unrealistic for people. So 5 years is something a lot more concrete. It's something a lot more that you can imagine and see for yourself. So where would you ideally like to be in the next 5 years? You know, what would your finances look like? What would your career look like? What would your hobbies look like? What would your relationships with your family and friends look like? And of course, obviously, your love life as well. What about your health? Like, what do you want to look like? What do you want to be eating? Well, you know, what do you want your habits to be? And then when you've got kind of got an idea on those kind of outcomes of what you want to create for yourself in 5 years' time, you know, what can you do daily to help you get to that point, right? And it might be just small things, because obviously I talk about this sometimes, and it's like, some people are like, well, I can't do what I want to do because there's this blockage in the way. Like, perhaps it might be a money thing. Like, I don't have enough money to start my business, so therefore I'm not going to start right now. I'm going to wait until I get more money. Don't wait. Don't wait for the conditions to be perfect. right? Think about what you can do now with your current resources, because for whatever reason, you might not have enough money to go to the gym, right? For example, right? So what can you do? Like, what can you, have you got any items in your home that you can lift up? You know, it might be like a bag of potatoes or something, or it could be like a can of beans because you don't have, you can't afford to buy weights or something. Obviously you've got an internet connection, otherwise you wouldn't be watching this. So you might be looking up like workout videos on YouTube that you can do because you have an internet connection. So that's something that you can do. You might not be able to afford a gym membership, but you can watch obviously YouTube and YouTube videos. So that might be able to help you. That might be something that you can integrate into your daily actions. You might want to become a writer, right? But you feel like, well, I can't afford a website to write to start a blog. But you know, there's other free tools that you can use. There's like blogspot.com, things like that. Those are free things that you can use right now that don't require any money that you can start doing, so you can start practicing, right? There's plenty of things. So you kind of have to think out of the box, especially if you don't have the resources to live the life that you want to live. So you need to think about things that you can do daily, things that is within your power to do, and start creating that life that you've always wanted. Because you know, great things start small. That, like, the cliche, Rome wasn't built in a day, it was built brick by brick. So that's kind of what you need to see yourself as. You need to kind of see yourself as there's something that you need to build brick by brick, and it may be slow, it may take a long time, but if you do daily action on these things that are really important to you, eventually you will get there. And it may be a case of you can't really be consistent right now, because let's say you've never done these things in the past. So an example of this that I use a lot is like New Year's Eve, right? So everyone has like these grand things that they want to do, these New Year's resolutions. One of them might be like exercise, right? And they're like, well, I'm going to work out for an hour a day if for every single day this year, right? But unfortunately, because they've never been consistent with that kind of workout in the past, it's kind of unrealistic. And then they usually give up by the end of January or in February or something. You know, it doesn't last long. So to someone like that, I would say, you need to start being consistent first and then add up that extra time over time to get to the hour. So that might be just, you know, exercising for 15 minutes a day. You know, that sounds something easily and manageable, right? And then you can add it to an hour over time. But the first thing that you need to do is become consistent with it. Instead of focusing on writing a whole book, just focus on writing a page a day. You know, do those small daily things. Do things that are easily and manageable, right? Because sometimes, you know, we kind of have to treat ourselves like babies, right? Because we have all these like bad habits that we've accumulated over the years. We have these like thought patterns that are not really productive, that are not very good for us. So basically we need to treat ourselves like children. Like, okay, I'll do 15 minutes of this and then I'll do 20 minutes of that. You know, you kind of have to do it like that to begin with, especially if you haven't been consistent in the past. And when you start focusing on these different things, your love life is not going to be as important to you. You're not going to have as much emotion behind, you know, your relationships. It's not going to be your primary focus anymore, because your primary focus is on reaching this person that you want to be and living this life that you want to live in 5 years' time. So therefore, it's so much easier for you to walk away. It's so much easier for you to remain in no contact, because that person, that this situation in your love life is no longer that important. I highly recommend that you go and watch this video called The Art of Improvement to help you more with this kind of thing. Also, if you like this video and you enjoyed the information so far, then please leave a like on it, and please do subscribe if you haven't done so already. If you'd like coaching with me, then please go to www.christineloveridge.com, and on the shop page of that website, you'll be able to find a free PDF download, which is a dating and relationships manual. If you do read that, and if you have any critiques, please let me know so I can make it the best product possible for those people that want it. Thank you so much for watching, and I shall talk to you again very soon. Goodbye, guys.